And he will do that. You see, God always answers your prayers, especially if your prayer is something which is going to help you grow spiritually. He does it for all of us. New cars may be a little difficult to come by, but spiritual help, anything that will help us grow spiritually and grow toward Him and grow toward His ideal for us and help us to become willing to live our lives by spiritual principles. Any of that, we'll get that answered right away. Boom, 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 boom. It doesn't mean God's hand's going to come down and slap us around the face. It means that we're going to find circumstances, we're going to find events, and we're going to find people appearing in our life who will be there to help us and show us, either by teaching us or by their example, that this is the way we are to solve the problem. And He always does that for us. Now listen to this. We remembered always that our sex powers were God-given and therefore good. Well, wait a minute. Gosh, we've been hearing, well, you know, what's the fun of doing this stuff if it's good? I was doing it because it was bad. I was doing it because I thought I was getting away with something. But wait a minute. It says our sex powers are God-given and therefore good. It does not say that our sexual activities in any direction we wish to go are good. It says our sex powers are given and therefore good. God-given. This means that we're dealing here with a natural God-given instinct. Now remember always that an instinct is something which operates below the level of conscious thought. This is not something over which we have conscious control. You do not have to think, I am attracted to her. And by the way, I would like to go to bed with her. Because this is not something that we whomp up in our heads. We don't engender these things. They're there. The sex instinct, it's an instinct. It directs us from the back here in the medulla oblongata. This is the automatic stuff that we have no power over. That's why we can't get rid of these defects ourselves, because they operate below the level of conscious thought. These are all the warping of natural instincts. That's what a defect is. That's why we have to have God's help. He got to straighten out the stuff that He gave us that was perfect when we got it. And because of the life we've lived, it's become warped and perverted by fear. And He got to come back into our lives and help us straighten it out. And He will. And He does. And He restores us to sanity. So all this stuff's pretty simple. God-given and therefore good, neither to be used lightly or selfishly, nor to be despised and loathed. And how many times does that latter admonition come into play? So many people have been so beaten up around the head and shoulders that they believe that their sex powers are nasty, rotten, immoral, terrible. That these are the kinds of things which even to think about it is going to throw us into the depths of hell. Well, if God intended us to have sexual thoughts and aspirations and desires, I doubt very much if He would make that as a one-way ticket to hell. Now, perhaps that's true, but I seriously doubt it. And so, but many people are scared to death of sex. How many times do you talk to some, especially you gals who do a lot of sponsoring of women? I'm going to be celibate the rest of my life. And you say to yourself, you're a wise sponsor, say, sure, okay. Oh, yeah, sure, okay. But tell me, Mary Jane Lou, why? Well, look what happened. You can't trust men, and they do this to you, do that to you. And you just say to yourself, just stick around, honey. You're going to be all right.